there's many causes of defective rolls that actually can cost companies a lot of money. And the last thing a manufacturing, a converting company wants to see is a truck backing up to the loading dock to unload rolls that they already shipped because they didn't meet specification and the customer can't use them and doesn't want them. So by understanding the theoretical geometry of slitting and the dynamics involved relative to force and friction and those types of things, operators are better able to resolve problems in the fastest way possible. Thing that a company should do is to ensure that operators and process engineers have the training and understand what is going to happen or what potentially could happen relative to what I first mentioned about understanding the process of the geometric and the dynamics of slitting. It's extremely important. The second thing is to do is to give them the tools that they can use to have satisfactory throughput in the machine. Well, are there perfect rolls? Well, there may be, but there are not many. Rolls that are acceptable to the customer, there are very many. And being able to produce those kinds of rolls is important. Chasing the perfect roll might be too much an investment and take too much time. It's meeting the specifications that your customers ask for. Electronics and introduction to the slitting systems and the slitting arrangements have had a tremendous impact and have opened the door for much more of a positive impact on the whole production process. Electronic knife holders came on the market and with little servo motors in them, and they helped a HMI screen start a menu of operation that sets the overlap depth and the side engagement depth on knife holders. And then electronics have moved into positioning multiple knives. And very basically, the first positioning systems, automatic systems, were patented in the U.S. by the Beloit Corporation in around 1965. And what that was a system where all the knives were located, and a device went along, saw where every knife was located, then went out and moved one at a time the knives. Nowadays, we have simultaneous positioning, and one very interesting system that I saw was a crush cut system that had 100 knife holders, a half inch wide, and they all relocate at the same time. All 100 knives have their own little drive motor, electronic drive motor, and they all move at the same time. So they could, depending on the menu, where they need to be, they can move all the knives in 10 seconds. And they also have the capability through the computer system to use knives 1, 3, 5, 7 for weeks at a time, and then without changing anything on the machine, next time use 2, 4, 6, 8. So it's enormous capabilities. Today there are supervisory data gathering systems called SCADA systems, where they collect information, digital information from any device on a slitter rewinder that uses electronics that can output a signal. And combining that with electronic slitting equipment really has made a major impact on the slitting process improvements. The there's a lot of common knowledge relative to what slitting is best for a certain type of material. It all slitting and all winding starts with what's the material. Is it stretchy? Is it really tough? Is it delicate? How fast are you going to run? All the aspects of operation and the material itself. And the best thing that could be done if a company is looking to start a new web material is to look for a knife supplier who might be able to run trials on some material in their laboratory, where your technical people could go and they could see in operation and examine the results in a controlled laboratory environment. Beyond that is converting houses that do slitting for many, many different companies, is to buy some time there. And then third, which is not always the easiest thing to do, is to find time in the production environment to run some trials on materials yourself.